DCF, it's one of the most powerful concepts in finance that you can use in your personal life too when you are evaluating new investments. So it's important that you spend some time to understand it. In this video, you'll learn about DCF and all the underlying concepts like free cash flows, WACC, discount factor, terminal value, net present value, and all the formulas required to build a simple DCF model in Microsoft Excel. You'll also learn where DCF can be used along with the pros and cons. There's a lot to learn, so stay glued to your seat and watch the full video. Suppose you're an investor and an investment banker suggests that you buy a stock or acquire a company and tells you that the price quoted is fair price. You'll wonder how he concluded that the price is indeed fair. The banker says he used DCF analysis to arrive at the fair price. So what is DCF? The full form of DCF is discounted cash flow. DCF is a valuation method to estimate the present value of an investment using its future cash flows. Cash flows are payments an investor receives in a given period for making an investment or for owning shares or bonds. To be technically correct for a wider range of applications such as company valuations, they're called free cash flows. In simple terms, free cash flow is the cash left over after a company pays for its operating expenses and capital expenditures. DCF is used by investment bankers and financial analysts to recommend to investors a fair price for selling or buying a company and to find out whether a stock is a good buy or not. It can also be used to find out the commercial viability of a new project that requires a significant upfront investment. A DCF analysis is based on the concept of time value of money, or TVM, according to which money available now, that is at the present time, is worth more than an identical sum in the future. Why? Because money available now can be invested immediately to earn returns in the form of interest or dividend. The other aspect is that an identical sum that may be available in the future may be of a lower value than money available right now due to factors such as inflation acting on it. The goal of a DCF analysis is to analyze an asset that is expected to provide returns over a few years and calculate what it is worth today using the concept of time value of money and forecasts about the future returns that an investment is expected to bring. A DCF analysis evaluates the viability of an investment using a discount rate. The investment is viable or profitable if the net present value, or NPV, of expected future cash flows is positive. That is, if it adds up to more than the initial investment. And if the NPV is negative, that's less than the initial investment, then the project is not viable. NPV is calculated by discounting the future cash flows using the discount rate. Usually a DCF analysis estimates how much cash flow an investment will generate over a fixed duration, like 5 or 10 years. These future cash flows are discounted to assess their value at present. That is, adjustments are made to know their value over time. The discount rate reflects two things. The time value of money, because investors are getting paid in the future rather than at present. And a risk premium, because future cash flows carry the risk that they may not come at all. In business, the discount rate is typically a company's weighted average cost of capital, or WACC. This is the required rate of return that investors expect from investments in the company. The WACC is calculated by multiplying the cost of each capital source, debt and equity, by its relevant weight, and then adding the products together. The calculation formula for WACC may seem a little difficult to understand at first, but it becomes easier if you break it down into its components. For instance, for a bond, the discount rate is equal to the interest rate on the security. The discount rate can also be conceived as the money you would earn if you invested it in another opportunity that carries the same risk. A good guideline is to use the current interest rate on loans. To use the DCF formula effectively, the investor should set an appropriate discount rate depending on the project or investment opportunity. If the project is too complex and the investor cannot make a reasonable estimate of future cash flows, then the DCF formula cannot be used to assess the returns from the project. Okay, we've covered enough theory. So let's look at some examples to bring these ideas to life. In a DCF analysis, the discount rate is the degree to which future cash flows are discounted in the NPV calculation. For example, if a project with an initial investment of $3,000 is estimated to give returns of $1,000 each for 5 years, one might assume that the total returns would be $5,000, right? Wrong. Let's see why. Assume that the discount rate is estimated at 10%. At the end of the first year, the return is $1,000. Applying a discount rate of 10%, the present value of this return is $909. For now, don't worry about how we got that figure. We'll cover that formula soon. Just try to understand this concept better. Here's a little trick to do that. Think what happens when you invest $909 for a year at 10% interest. You'll get $1,000 next year. Discounting is the exact same concept of compounding, but in reverse. Using the discounting formula for the years 2 to 5, the present values for each year will be as follows. The total returns in the 5 years will be $3,791 as opposed to $5,000. We are now able to calculate the net present value by deducting the initial investment of $3,000 from the total returns of $3,791. Our NPV is $791, which is a positive number, which means the project will give you positive discounted cash flows that are greater than your initial investment. In other words, the investment is worth it. But if your initial investment had been $4,000 instead of $3,000, the discounted cash flows would have added up to less than the initial investment, making the NPV negative. The project would have not been profitable. Knowing this upfront, you can avoid investing in it. Here's the formula for calculating DCF. To make the DCF model easier to interpret, the cash flows are often segregated from the multiplier. In this case, the multiplier is called the discount factor. In our example, we've projected the cash flows for 5 years, but you can extend it for any period. Let's look at a DCF example where we show discount factors and the cash flows separately. Suppose a company plans to invest $1 million to buy new equipment to improve its manufacturing process and increase profits. Let's say the discount rate of the investment is estimated at 5%. In such cases, a company uses its weighted average cost of capital, or WACC, which reflects the shareholders' expectation of the average rate of return from investments in the company. In the next 5 years, the project expects these cash flows. Using the DCF formula, the discounted cash flows look like this. The total DCF is around $1.2 million. Deducting the initial investment of $1 million, you get an NPV of around $256,000, which is a positive number, so the investment is worth it. What if the initial investment had been $2 million? With the same cash flows, you would have got an NPV of around minus $765,000, a negative number, so the investment would have not been worth it. Here's how you can build a simple DCF model in Microsoft Excel. For the same example, you can pause the video to check out the formula for each cell. As an investor, you cannot take a fair price estimated by an investment banker or financial analyst through a DCF analysis as the last word. It doesn't have to be accurate after all. This is because the formula to calculate DCF contains variables, particularly the discount rate or estimated value of money in the future. And these can go up or down depending on many circumstances affecting a DCF analysis. If you make a few adjustments to the variables, the estimated value of an investment can change easily. If highly optimistic projections of cash flows are made, the return is going to be exaggerated. If low projections are made, the investor may not participate in the project and may lose the investment opportunity. In many cases, the cash flows from a project or company are likely to continue beyond the considered time frame. That's where the concept of terminal value comes into the picture. It's a separate amount that captures the cumulative cash flows beyond the 5 or 10 year DCF period. It is based on a more conservative and long-term growth rate, typically aligned with the growth rate of the industry in which the company operates, or GDP, or inflation. Here's how it's calculated. Often the terminal value of a DCF analysis accounts for a large percentage, sometimes up to 50% of the estimated total value of a company being evaluated for purchase. Any changes in the terminal value may significantly impact the result of the DCF analysis. A DCF analysis is used to estimate the value of an entire business, to value a bond or shares in a company, to value revenue-generating property, and to value the benefit of cost-saving programs in the company. The analysis also comes in handy when you need to find out how much money to invest for getting a certain expected return. Here are some examples of business cases where a DCF analysis can be used. A quick point on the timeframes that you need to use for DCF modeling. For investments in equipment, shorter timeframes may be used. But for investments in whole, stable businesses, timeframes of 10 years or longer could be more appropriate to capture the economic cycle variations. Alternatives to the DCF analysis include the comparables method, precedent transaction analysis, and adjusted present value. Here are some advantages of using discounted cash flows and some disadvantages. If all this sounds a little overwhelming at first, watch the video a few more times and create your own DCF model. Also, check out the description for further resources to learn more about finance. If you wish to work in the high-paying world of finance, you'll also need a strong qualification, such as an MBA. That's the part where MBA Crystal Ball Consultants can help. We've mentored many professionals who are now working in the top investment banking, venture capital, private equity, and consulting firms around the world. Send us an email if you need professional career counseling or MBA admissions consulting help. Good luck!